linear inequalities, okay, once with just one variable in there. Now you can see it starts with problem type 4. It's just the one that I chose. You know, this lesson is going to correspond with all problem types 1 through 5. All right, so it says simplify your answer as much as possible. That kind of might indicate that we might have a fraction in our answer. Now here's what's going to happen here. When I do this, I am going to make it so I get a negative number in front of the variable. You don't have to do that, all right? I'm doing that for a specific reason because I want to show you what happens or what can happen in certain kinds of problems. Excuse me. So what's going to happen here is when I try to get the W on the left side, this is what's going to happen. I know that I have 8/3, so I'm going to have to add 8/3 W. And when I add 8/3 W to both sides, I'm obviously going to need some common denominators. And so if I wanted to, I know that negative 18 over 3 has the common denominator. It also reduces to negative 6. All right, so if negative 18 minus 8, that would be negative 26 over 3 times W. All right? So that's a little bit of a shortcut that you could use there if you're working with fractions. We know that the plus 7 is going to carry down. We know it's greater than or equal to minus 8, or greater than or equal to negative 8. We could subtract 8 from both sides. Negative 26 over 3 W is greater than or equal to negative 15. All right, now in order to get rid of this fraction, we know to multiply by the reciprocal. Okay, not the negative reciprocal, but the same number. Now, here's what happens here. Okay, when I multiply by a negative, the sign is going to flip, okay? I'm going to do that, and then I'll give you an explanation here. So it's W is greater than or equal to. If you want to, you can see if you can cross-cancel. It doesn't look like you can. So we have 45 over 26. 26 over 45 cannot be reduced, and so that's our final answer. Now I'm going to give an explanation of why you flip the sign. If you don't want to hear that explanation, you can move on to the next, or just keep, you can fast forward through the video until it goes to the next screen, and then you can try one on your own. All right, so here's the explanation. Let's say I'm going to fill in the blank here. Okay, that's the direction. All right, and the blank says, all right, well, I have these two numbers. I have 5 and I have a 3, you know. So which one's bigger? You have to use a greater than, a less than, or an equal sign. Obviously, we're going to use a greater than sign. Okay. Now, let's say this. We know that if we do something to one side of an equation or an inequality, we have to do it to the other side. So let's say I'm going to multiply them both by 2. All right, and let's see what happens. I know I have a 10, I know I have a 6, and look. The symbol doesn't change. But watch what happens. What if I multiply it by 2 again, but this time not a positive 2, but a negative 2? What happens is I have a negative 20 when I multiply and a negative 12. Now, which one's bigger? This one is right here. So if you multiply both sides, in fact, or divide both sides by a negative, of an inequality, just flip the sign, okay? So that's one of the big things with these inequality signs. If you multiply or divide by a negative, flip the sign. On to the next slide here. Okay, if we're moving on to the next slide, I want you to try this one. Try to get V by itself. It doesn't have to have a negative number in front. It could have a positive number in front. You do it the way that fits you best. All right, so we have this problem. I chose to get the letters on the left again. This time it worked out positive, so I added 3/4. 5 plus 3/4 is yes, 5 and 3/4, but I changed it to an improper fraction because I knew later on down the road I'd have to multiply by the reciprocal. So I did that. It, remember, it's just 5 times 4, 20 plus 3 to get the 23. I added 7 to both. both sides, I multiply by the reciprocal. 16 times 4 is 64 times 23. Always look to reduce. 23 is a prime number, so nothing's going to reduce with that. So it's V is greater than or equal to 64 23rds. All right, let's take a look at one other kind of problem here. And we're just using some inequalities here with the mean. Now, we have Frank, and he's participating in a cross-country bike challenge. And we know that he has 4 days, and he has to do this, and he's done 74, 61, and 55 miles, respectively, on the first 3 days. How many miles does he need to bike? So his average is 62 miles per day. Now, this word is important. It's not an inequality sign. It says it is 62. All right? So we have the 3 days so far, plus the fourth day. And if we're trying to find the mean or the average, we're going to divide it by 4. All right? So let's go ahead and combine some like terms. We know that we have 74. We have a 61 and a 55. When we add those all together, we have 190 plus x over 4 equals 62. Which one are we going to get rid of first? The 4 or the 190? It has to be the 4. Okay, the 4 is divided by the entire thing, or is dividing the entire side. So we have 248. And then x plus 190 equals that. So if we subtract 190 from both sides, x equals 58 miles. All right. Let's see if we can come up with another one, another type of that problem. Okay. Again, it's the same thing. We have 4 scores on his first 4 tests, but he wants to know what his next test is going to be. So it's 81. Plus 87, plus 75, plus 70. Now again, we need that next test, so it's plus x all over 5. There's 5 total things, and we want it to be at least 79. Okay, pause this video and see if you can come up with what x equals. All right, so we added our setup, combined some like terms, multiplied by 5 on both sides, subtracted 313, and the next score that he best get is 82. Now, I don't know if that's percent. I don't know if, maybe it's 82 out of a 200. I'm not quite sure. I'm assuming it's percent, just because that's what we're talking about here, as far as the answer goes. But be careful with